Hello and welcome back to Loudmouse, the podcast for three loud people talking the rooms about random shit. I'm your host, Brandon, aka Wild Spartans, and we have Quite.
Hi.
And we also have Diesel.
I just woke up.
Yeah, he did, and he was almost late. So, Diesel and Quite, I have good and bad news for you today. Bad news first. An Oklahoma woman was mauled to death by a pack of wiener dogs.
How's that bad news?
Well, I'm sorry for her loss.
I apologize to that woman's family. I hope you're able to lay her to rest in peace. I'm so sorry.
Nah, fam, that shit's fucking hilarious. I can't wait to talk about that at the funeral.
Yeah, it's especially funny because the officers reported that none of the dogs actually weighed over 40 pounds.
Yeah, apparently they're covered in like fleas and ticks, so they're probably neglected or some shit.
Yeah, so like it's just a pack of like angry wiener dogs.
It's kind of depressing, to imagine what those fucking dogs went through. But like at the same time, that sounds.
It's
like
also pretty depressing to imagine being mauled to death by a pack of dogs.
That sounds like that scenario sounds like something from an Adam Sandler movie.
It really does. It sounds like something someone would just bring up conversation and be like, "That woman was mauled to death by a pack of wiener dogs."
This sounds like a joke you'd, like Diesel would make in the Reddit video. Can you imagine getting mauled to death by a pack of wiener dogs?
It really does.
I sound like a mobster from like a Martin Scorsese film. Okay,
I want you to go to the fucking Reddit video that we made, and I want you to listen to you say, "Can you imagine taking a nude pic with your dog on the bed?" That's exactly what you sound like. I want you to listen to that clip.
and then in good news, Japan is getting a Hello Kitty bullet train.
How is that
Which
good
is totally
news?
Not a surprise.
How is that How good is it? News? Because
it's a fucking Hello Kitty bullet train. That's why it's good news.
Wait, that's not the bad news?
No, that's the good news.
Oh. I'm joking, obviously, but good news. Yeah. I know somebody in the audience probably won't get that, but I just had to be careful, cover my bases.
How fast do bullet trains go?
Super fast.
I think it's
Sonic
like,
speed.
I want to say it's 200 miles per hour. So like imagine... There's a Hello Kitty bullet train that exists that goes 200 miles per hour.
Imagine, like, standing on the track and, like, the last thing you see before you die is, like, the fucking, like, on the front of the train is just a giant Hello Kitty face and it runs you the fuck over.
Yeah, there's just, like, the Hello Kitty theme song playing in the fucking background as you run over.
You know the fucking, like, meme in that one vine where it's, like, Harry Potter and Ron Weasley are in the fucking car. They're about to get run over by the Hogwarts Express, but instead of the Hogwarts Express, it's Thomas the Tank Engine. Imagine if it's that Hello Kitty bullet train.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
That was the most elaborate setup for a joke. I'm very glad. And then you described it to us.
Pictionary, but with vines.
Pictionary, but with vines. So you just described a 6-second vine.
Yes.
Except I replaced
Thomas the Tank Engine with this Hello Kitty bullet train that is in Japan.
How is Thomas the Tank Engine like still a relevant meme to any extent?
Because it's fucking part of everybody's childhood. It's so good.
That's true. Is the show even still on? Like, is there still a Thomas?
They're probably doing
show?
Reruns. I don't know if there's new stuff.
Really?
I feel like it's fallen off in like fucking like the minds of fucking like kids today. Like it's not part of anybody new kids' childhood.
Well, yeah, a lot of the new kid shows are just fucking Disney Channel with
Fanboy and Chum Chum.
Fanboy and Chum Chum was the ugliest cartoon that I have ever seen in my entire fucking life.
I don't
life.
Remember that cartoon. I remember the name, but I don't remember that cartoon.
I remember it's watching hideous. A couple episodes and like not being a huge fan, but I'm like, this just isn't me.
Fanboy and Chum Chum. Is that what it's called?
Everyone looks sickly. Whoever's a character.
Oh,
that
wait. I think I know. Yeah, I remember this cartoon. I remember this cartoon. I like this cartoon.
Of course, Brandon, the man of... Taste.
I didn't watch it that often. I watched
literally
it
taste. He loves tasting things.
Could be bad, good. He's gonna put it in his
true.
Mouth. Oh, that's
very true.
That's a little something else.
It's a little innuendo-ish.
Speaking of something else, Alinity. Alinity.
Speaking of something else, gee, I wonder why. Oh, these transitions are just getting worse. We're not getting better at them.
It's okay, because it's funny. So we have Alinity and Collab DRM copyright claiming PewDiePie. Now, Diesel, you have something to say?
About copyright claiming, or...
Wait, it was about copyright claiming in general, wasn't it?
No, I mean, I got copyright claimed on my video recently about Nicole Arbour, but this, like... Fucking, this is a complete overreach of, like, the system. But this has been happening for years. Like, this is...
Yeah, this
stories like this happen all the time.
To be fair, it has died down. And for people who don't exactly know what we're talking about, basically a Twitch streamer by the name of Alinity went on stream and quote-unquote said, can we copy strike PewDiePie? Then it so happened that the person that she signed with to copyright claim content, copyright claim PewDiePie, and apparently she had no control at all because she surrendered her control to Collab DRM, which is the company that copyright claimed it. But I just think Alinity is a super ignorant person who didn't understand it at all and just signed up because she's like, hey, free money, because her excuse was like, hey, this company gave me $700 last month. I make good money.
She said she's trying to get out of it now, though, I think.
I don't know. Like, she just came off as, like, so arrogant. It was just like, yeah. It's like, I make good money off of claiming people's videos. I made $700. It's like, God.
Yeah. I mean, like, if you watch, like, the interview that she gave Philly D, it sounds like that she was, like, or she, like, tried to come off, like, in that interview, like, she was just kind of trying to assert herself because she was being, like, abused in comments. Just think that's worth mentioning. I don't know how true that is. I'm too lazy to watch that stream.
Yeah, but I mean, it's like, but, like, I understand the perspective, and I understand Philly D's approach, but at the same time, I also understand PewDiePie's response to Philly D's approach of him saying he was white-knighted, because, like, Philly D was totally, like, ignoring the fact that she was just blatantly ignorant to copyright, and it's like, if Philly D just acknowledged, it's like, obviously, Alinity is blatantly ignorant to copyright, and she shouldn't have signed with this person, or at least done research, right? But he, like, completely ignored that. Because, like, at the end of the day, it was on her. She did sign her will to this company, and she did absolutely no fucking research, you know? And then she went on stream. Yeah, and then she went on stream bragging about copy-striking fucking PewDiePie.
Can we copy-strike PewDiePie?
I don't know how you can be in this field and not have a rough understanding of how fair use and copyright law works, because those are two of the main things that are affecting creators these days. On top of that, you should always read the contracts when you sign with the company. I mean, I read the contract when I signed with the Mind Network. You know, that's something you do.
Yeah.
Obviously, you're not going to be as well versed as a lawyer, but you should at least have that rough understanding.
Yeah, I mean,
you know?
Yeah, you're not going to understand half the words.
A lot
at least,
of,
you know, read it.
A lot of the fucking ignorance, I think, comes from like people who maybe they're not like they just kind of fall into the position that they're in. They don't exactly like get there by like working intentionally at it every day. Like they just follow into it by luck.
Yeah, but then you gotta do your business to like get caught up to speed.
Yeah, like I don't know how much of Alinity that it like how much that like is accurate to Alinity, but like I wouldn't be surprised. Like,
I mean,
yeah, like obviously, like anybody who's in that position obviously works for it, even like if luck played a large factor in it. But it's like a lot of people like just don't like deign to do further research after they're there.
When you get to a certain point, though, you become like you're responsible to look into things, you know.
Exactly.
Like,
it
becomes your responsibility to look into like copyright and what you can and can't do, and look into the TOS of the website to make sure you don't lose your account, you know, things like that. And it's like, as a Twitch streamer, it's not that hard to like get familiar with copyright, especially when most of the time, if you're a Twitch streamer, you've probably had your VODs claimed or like silenced because of music. So like you at least get some curiosity peak of like, why is this muted? Oh, copyright? How does copyright work? How does fair use work? And that should lead into it. But, like, I don't know. She probably doesn't give a shit. So, I mean,
she clearly has a rough understanding.
Hopefully she'll learn from this and, like, start taking an interest in it. That's the best outcome I think we can hope for.
Yeah, she said she was learning from it in her response, I believe. But
I hope
like,
so. I hope so. I haven't watched her response, but I hope she's taken something away from it.
Yeah, she definitely needs to.
Like,
because, like, it was such a dumb fucking situation. She was so fucking ignorant. Can we copy strike PewDiePie?
Yeah. I think I like this situation more than like certain other ones where it's like intentionally fucking like just trying to fuck over people because you don't like what they're saying. Like obviously she was doing this because she's ignorant, but I think there's like room to learn from there, which is good.
Yeah, I mean, like to be honest, I really don't like Philly D's response.
I thought his was fine. I'll be honest, I didn't think it was
bad. Philly D's overall response of like trying to play devil's advocate for Alinity, like that was fine, but he should have at least acknowledged that like, hey, she was very ignorant, you know, and like she should have done research. He shouldn't have just been like, oh, it's the big bad company's fault, because at the end of the day she did sign to have her content or her copyrighted content be claimed. She signed for that, you know? So at the end of the day, it's her fault.
Speaking on like YouTube copyright, like as a bigger issue on the website, like while it has died down, I remember something like this similar happened to Pyro, and I mentioned it to my video in my video on like this whole topic. But like the dispute process is just super flawed, right?
No, it's fucking garbage. I have a Diesel and I have a rant. Okay, so basically, any video I make that includes any type of other content, regardless of how long it takes to make and how obviously fair use it is, it will get fucking claimed, right? The only video, the only two videos I have that aren't claimed are trying to watch in terms of group content, it's trying to watch Lily Pons and then trying to watch Dr. Phil. Trying to watch Dr. Phil 2 was fucking claimed, right? Appealed the claim. They're like, nah, it's not fair use. It's like, oh, 12 hours of editing doesn't constitute fair use when it's clearly fucking fair use, you know? It's like, that annoyed me. And then trying to watch Lil Tay was claimed. Not by Lil Tay. By fucking Jake Paul. Jake Paul. Because what? I used one Jake Paul video in there. And then Scale Lab was like, hey, this is Jake Paul. And I'm like, what?
Wait,
you can't just...
Wait, he's partnered with Scale Lab?
Apparently, yeah. Like, the claim, it says claim at Scale Lab channel Jake Paul. So, I've been claimed by fucking Jake Paul off of audiovisual content on Try to Watch Lil Tay, which I'm considering tweeting at Scale Lab being like, this is obviously fair use, because I did appeal, and I'm like, this is blatantly fair use. It is totally fair use. I'm like, nah, not fair use. So, asshats, like, these big fucking companies can just take your money away. And it's like it's not even that much money to them. It's like maybe, like, to them, it's fucking chump change. But, like, to me, that would have been the difference between, like, $200 to $400 or something, you know? It's like, that's just fucking gone now. And it's like, then CBS claimed the Dr. Phil one. Fucking.
I guess the logic behind claiming that is, like, they claim a bunch of videos and it adds up.
I mean, yeah, exactly. It's like how Freedom's Network's tactic is to, like, get as many fucking partners in as possible.
Yeah, and it's like a fucking... what was the example I was going to use? Okay, I just brain farted. Never mind.
George Van Oost. Right,
your turn.
No.
If I remember what I was going to say, I'll...
Okay.
I'll interrupt you.
Yes. Just like that.
Yeah.
So, Colab DRM is a network, right? Like an MCN?
I don't think
I think they're, like, the part of a... Part of a network, like it's an arm of a larger network. It has to be, though.
It could be an arm. I'm pretty sure all they do is copyrights.
Yeah, I was gonna say that's
literally a digital rights management company. It seems like I'm not exactly sure.
Collab Digital Rights Management helps content owners claim the full value of their content. Yeah, so basically they just claim shit.
Okay, so I mean, first of all, I'm not a big fan of a company like that on our platform.
Same.
But MCNs have total overreaching power because, like, you know, Scale Labs claiming your video with Jake Paul when it's very clearly fair use. First of all, the appeal process is absolutely trash. Like, I was just filling it out yesterday, and I'm like, "What? Why do I have to say this is fair use and then repeat it in the little box that says it's fair use and why it's fair use? Like, it's obviously fair use, but, you know, I'll elaborate twice the same fucking sentence."
Yeah, my issue with it came in, like, when, like, you have to fucking give them your contact info. Like, that shit's shady as hell.
Yeah, that's super stupid. I had to, like, sign it with a digital signature.
Like, you don't get theirs when they're the fucking claimant, and they still decide, like, they still decide whether, like, they fucking keep the claim up. They can just strike down your video at that point. It's fucking stupid.
And there's
and if it's just some random ass bozo who doesn't actually own the rights to that, like it happened to Pyro, like, a while ago, like, if they get your fucking info because you're trying to dispute it, they can just leak that shit easy.
Yeah, and then it's like, there's no repercussions for the people making the claims. But there's repercussions for people appealing the claims, you know? Like,
yeah.
If you appeal it twice, you could get a strike. If you appeal it the second time. So it's like, no one's going to fucking appeal it the second time. And even worse, you could get sued. So no one's going to appeal it the second time.
Is that the situation where, like, your money gets put in limbo, or is that, like, a different kind of claim?
If your content, when your content is claimed, it is put between each party until the end of the month. So, like, every month, I think the cycle refreshes or something like that.
Okay.
Yeah, so a claimant has a month to respond to your dispute, and then when they respond, if they find that it is in fair use and that it was a mistake, then they'll repeal the claim. Otherwise, they can go ahead forward with the claim, take all the money from the video, and then you have to refile a dispute.
Yeah, it's better than what it used to be, because originally it was like fucking like they content ID claim it, they get the money from it regardless. Even if like they say it's fine, they still get to keep that money. So a lot of them would just like wait till the end of that month period and like they take all the money that they could from that in that month period.
Yep.
And so it has gotten better, but it's still trash.
Yeah, there needs to be some kind of repercussion for the people making claims, because people shouldn't be able to just like falsely claim a bunch of content and get away with it.
Maybe if like they're found to make so many false claims, like ones that like are easily removed by like people like Trusted Flagger per se, maybe they should like have some of their ability to claim suspended, because they're being super liberal with how they fucking claim people.
Yeah, the problem is though, is YouTube doesn't want to step in between any of this shit, because they've already gotten in lawsuits over this kind of stuff back in like 2014 or 15, I think.
From who?
So like they've gotten in lawsuits over this shit.
Viacom.
They was it Viacom?
Yeah, it was Viacom.
Yeah, so like they don't want to step in between it, because they just don't want to have to pay out lawsuits. They're just like, we're still making the money. Creators don't matter.
Why do our creators hate us?
God.
I think audio from Susan Wojcicki.
I understand that alinity is an issue, and that's totally like overreaching. I would consider it a type of censorship. It's not direct censorship, but it's like it's taking away the incentivization of a creator to talk about a certain topic. You know?
Yeah, exactly.
So that I don't like. But more often than not, what I've seen from my time, and even when I used to do journalism stuff, is that MCNs are the ones that do a lot of the overreaching. If they're not, like, copyright holders, if they're other creators on creators, like, what happens with MCNs is that they'll be the ones overreaching to try and defend their creators, and in turn defend themselves. And it's, like, not okay, but also I've seen tons of other issues with MCNs outside of, like, abusing copyright just as much as like claimants and copyright holders, which
MCNs are a mess for the most part.
I think it was like, you remember PewDiePie's like fucking new car video and how he had like the distorted Lamborghini in there?
Yeah, and then KSI's claimed it.
Yeah, except it wasn't KSI, it was his fucking network. Like, it's the MCNs.
That video's still down though.
Yeah, it's like MCNs like doing it in the place of creators that creates a lot of the issues.
Well, with certain MCNs, if you have like a managed status or something like that, you can actually opt in to Content ID. You yourself can opt in to Content ID. I think you might be able to quite. Basically, you go to your monetization settings and you turn on enable Content ID matches, and you can put a policy down, and then that video will be scanned throughout YouTube, and if it matches, you can get claims on other people's content. So if someone uses over, let's say, 25 to 30 seconds of your content, Content ID will pick it up and claim the video automatically.
Gotcha.
So like that could have just been set on. Like
automatic networks, stuff. Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah, networks claiming stuff was a huge problem back in like, I think, 2015, 2016. That was a pretty big problem for people where they just randomly claim shit. So.
Ah.
I was totally waiting for one of you to say something.
I know.
Okay, so the next topic is something we mentioned earlier. It's Nicole Arbour's rendition of This Is America, which I'm sure a lot of you have heard about it, but if you haven't, Nicole Arbour is the person who allegedly abused Matthew Santoro years back. She made the Dear Fat People video that made her look like an idiot. She made the Depression Is All in Your Head video, which made her look like even more of an idiot. And now her This Is America women's edit is just, it's real shit. Like, just music from a musical perspective, it's real shit. But and it completely misses the point of like, or maybe not misses the point, but it fucking like it's kind of hijacking like what Childish Gambino was trying to do with his video.
It was a shitty video.
Essentially, yeah.
Well, apparently the musical composition of Nicole Arbour's This Is America women's edit was so exact to the original composition of the original This Is America. And I got copyright claimed, so you know.
I feel like it would probably wasn't like the actual bits that like she did. It was probably the parts where she sampled the original like instrumental vocals from the actual piece. Because at the beginning, it's like that's the same fucking kind of gospel choir thing.
Yeah, that's what I think got claimed. But it just told me it was manually claimed, and it didn't like label a certain part of the video that it registered as being claimed. So someone went to the video, saw it,
fucking
and
annoying.
Claimed it.
Nah, Collab DRM does the same fucking thing where they don't tell you where the problem actually is in the video, and their excuse is it's like, hey, we're not here to help people infringe. We're here to hold up the rights to our content. Bullshit! You just don't want people to fucking appeal.
Yeah, like, if you don't tell them what you're claiming them for, they like, how do they fucking fight back? Like, how do they prove the specific part?
Yeah, like the best they can do is like every single piece of content that's not theirs that they use, they prove every single part individually is fair use, which is a whole lot of work.
Yeah, exactly. So it's like, fucking God.
But yeah, Nicole Arbour, am I right, guys? You know, oof, what a lady.
Diesel, what was like the details of her apology? Because I didn't.
Okay, so it wasn't an apology; it was a clarification because people misinterpreted her message. Her words, not mine. First off and foremost, because I was reading through the comments on my video, which, by the way, they're vitriolic and absolutely awful. But
wait, Diesel. They didn't misrepresent it. Never mind.
Okay.
I was gonna say like they didn't misinterpret it. They misrepresented it, but that's not what it says. It says
a lot of minorities felt that she was colonizing a black person's message, which I personally think this has less to do with race and more to do with Nicole constantly being a button pusher. But in her like clarification, she went through her video in like a text document and explained the things that people misinterpreted, you know? So essentially she was like, the woman breastfeeding in public shows how women get in trouble for breastfeeding in public. It's like, no shit, Nicole. People aren't angry with the message you were trying to spread. It was the avenue of delivery that was an issue.
It also sounded like horseshit.
Yeah, it's like... It's like fucking like this is America as opposed to be like a fucking like delivery of like Gambino's message through like a fucking vehicle of his culture, right? But someone trying to take that same vehicle of something that doesn't really belong to their culture and trying to like deliver a message of their culture like with someone like a vehicle of someone else's culture is just kind of it's weird. Like it's fucking janky, especially when like the original thing is making waves.
Let's be real here. The only reason Nicole Arbour made this women's edit of This Is America is for fucking views.
Yeah, that's what I said.
Exactly. It's literally there is no other fucking reason. Oh, big video blew up that's making people love Childish Gambino. I know what I'll do. I'll make This Is America women's edit and people will not like it because I'm not Childish Gambino, and then people will click it and watch it and give me dislikes and give me attention. And then that was her thought process. I'm pretty sure anyways. I don't know for certain, but
I don't think she's that smart.
No, she totally did it because This Is America was gaining a lot of views.
I think she understands outrage culture. I think it was because she constantly makes videos like Dear Fat People, Depression's in Your Head, like it's very obvious.
She has two videos called Dear Black People. She has two videos about ending gun violence. Like, she makes videos purposefully to outrage people on both sides of the fence. Like, she's not stupid, but she is an asshole. Like, she's completely aware of what she was doing, and she did that intentionally.
I might be dumb, but I'm not stupid.
Says Nicole Arbour.
She also said that it was like a parody in her her clarification letter, right? And then goes on in the next sentence to say it was a homage. So it kind of makes me think that she's kind of like worried that this might actually close some doors for her.
Of course it did.
Really?
She's like, oh, I'm trying to really get my voice as a comedian. It's like, Nicole, you've been doing comedy for 10 years and you're telling me that you don't have a voice for comedy yet? Like, are you serious?
How big is she in Canada? Like, is she relevant at all?
I have no clue.
I don't know.
Because, like, that's...
If she is, she's got to be super niche.
Well, she's like, a woman comedian in Canada. She probably has a decent following there, at least.
Yeah, but she says a lot of shit that probably pisses them off.
Yeah,
I'm surprised she hasn't been arrested in Canada.
That is a good point.
Does she even live in Canada, or is she in LA?
I'm pretty sure
she lives in Toronto, I think.
I don't know how the fuck she would get a visa to stay in America. Like, what's she going to put in our fucking visa application?
Well, I mean,
I made This Is America women's
visas from America to Canada are pretty loose.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, still, they wouldn't let her in because she's her. Is it all we have to say about Nicole Arbour?
Continue to go on, but I have 3 fucking videos on her, so, you know, you can just go and watch those instead.
Oh, so now you're plugging yourself. You're just like, quite now. You know better than him.
I mean, like, what else is there to say that hasn't been said?
Brandon, you're the biggest one here, both literally and figuratively. We got to do what we can.
We gotta plug ourselves on our own podcast.
Like,
yeah, you got a problem, bro?
I read the comments, and you know that video has like 50,000 views, so there's a lot of comments on it. And I was reading them, and it's just like a lot of people being very angry at her. And more specifically, I see a lot of people who are colored who are talking about it and really like saying how racist she is. But like, okay, here's a big surprise, guys. I'm not white. I'm the brown one on the podcast, you know? And so I talk about my experience with that. And
I'm the only white one.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Okay. Sorry. You're a hoodie. No, well, like, okay, Filipino. Okay. Anyway, just let me continue for a second.
Stop discriminating against me.
Well, yeah, you're saying quite white.
No, okay, you know what's really weird is that when you talk about, like, the idea, like, the liberal version of what, like, racism and oppression are, quite's never been oppressed by that logic, which is absolutely hilarious, but...
Yeah, he's a hoodie.
Yeah, I know, hoodies... Just our
Are you
privilege.
Kidding me? We're thrown around and worn by you people like skin.
Sometimes women steal them and keep them as trophies.
I continue.
But, you know, like, these people in the comments were, like, calling her all these racist things. And it's like, okay, well, if she's being racist, you saying racist things back, is that really, like, the answer to the equation here?
Yes.
How was she being racist?
She's being racist because Donald Glover made that, and a black person made that, and she's white, and she's taking that and making it her own. And you're not allowed to appropriate
that. I don't think it's that far-fetched at all to say that's not racist.
I think that's, like, the best argument you could make for it being racist, that she's hijacking, like, a black man's fucking, like, creation or some shit for her own purposes. Like, when that his message was supposed to, like bring attention to black issues. Which I see, but, like, I don't think it's... I don't think it's because she's racist. I think it's because she's, like, purposely trying to outrage people, like you said.
That's not really racist. Like, you can't... That's not really racist.
Yeah, no, she's not doing it because she hates black people. Like, everybody thinks she's doing it with the intention to hurt black people's feelings. That is not the intention. Her actual opinion on black people is she loves the black people. So, that's not her intention. Trump?
She tweets about him a lot.
Yeah.
Does she? Wait. I didn't see this. Wait.
Type in Nicole Arbor black people on Google.
I just did.
I mean, you know, we all have our kinks. I like goth girls. She likes other things.
I love
Oh, yeah,
friends.
She does like black guys.
There you go.
I don't even know if black guys went at Starbucks. And
That's why
like,
she was so mean to Matthew Santoro, because he was white.
Oof.
Well... I'm the least appropriate one to have on the podcast. I think it's official.
Quite.
Wait.
Yeah. Change the topic. Quick.
Black Ops 4 got announced. There's no Yay. Campaign.
That has the word black in it.
No!
Diesel. So, there's a fucking, there's a live stream event where, like, essentially a shit ton of Black Ops 4 stuff got revealed, right? And among them, we found out no campaign. The multiplayer got revealed. There was, like, three zombies trailers, a couple of which were kind of weird. And Battle Royale mode got announced.
Woo!
Wow.
Yeah, I'm actually go first.
Okay, so, Blackout, like, I think the Battle Royale mode could actually be kind of interesting. Like, I'm definitely going to cop the game just to see what it's about. But, like, they're going to have to, like they said in the trailer, they're really going to have to fucking justify it. Like, because getting rid of the campaign for this is going to, like, it's going to take some major justification.
Okay, personally, I never really cared about the campaign. I played the Black Ops 1 campaign, and I never played Black Ops 2 campaign or Black Ops 3 campaign. And I'm sure... Treyarch has the data of who played the campaign and if it was worth their money or not to make a campaign, and it definitely was probably not worth their money to make a campaign, so they didn't make a campaign.
No.
So, I mean, I'm more excited for the fact that the PC version is now on Battle.net or Blizzard app, or whatever the fuck they call it now, because that means Blizzard's helped with it, and it's not going to be a fucking mess, and the PC servers might actually work. So that's why I am... looking forward to it on the PC.
Because it might actually function for once.
Yeah, because it's like, PC cons are such a hit or fucking miss. Like, they're either really well done, or they're just such a mess. They just don't work at all.
To be fair, Treyarch is usually the ones that, like, they usually hit. Like, Black Ops 1 and 2 are pretty decent ports.
Yeah, like, Infinite Warfare on the PC was an awful fucking port. It ran like poop. then World War II is a decent port. And then this one I think is going to be a really good port because didn't Jeff, whatever the hell his name is, work Jeff on Kaplan. It? Yeah, Jeff Kaplan from Overwatch. Didn't they help with fucking making Black Ops 4?
Yeah, apparently Treyarch helped make Overwatch a good bit. I'd heard about that yesterday, but...
Which doesn't surprise me, because it's all under Activision. So they probably were just like, hey, we need someone who's good at making first-person shooters. And then, like, Treyarch's like, we're good at making first-person shooters. And then, they made Overwatch.
Just like that, yes.
Yeah.
I'm just realizing how big of a fucking monolith Activision is. Like, they own so many major IPs.
Yeah, and then no one looks at... Everyone looks at Activision as a bad guy, but no one looks at Blizzard as the bad guy. But Blizzard is published by Activision. And
I think Blizzard kind of handles itself better than a lot of other Activision properties, I guess.
That's true, because COD's usually a fucking mess. But, like, the only thing I'm worried about is, with Black Ops 4, is they're going to be making it, like, I feel like it might turn into Destiny.
No, it totally is. It's probably going to have that kind of, like, hub world that Destiny has, too. It's just going to be a vehicle for microtransactions and cosmetics.
Rip.
Yep.
What did you guys think of the zombies modes?
I only saw one trailer, and it was the fucking, like... It was like you were put in an arena, and you had swords.
That was kind of weird. Like, I didn't understand that one. The Voyage of Despair, it's like a Titanic map. That looked kind of cool.
New Year, same stuff.
The Mob of the Dead remake. Like, that's one of my favorite maps, so I'm kind of looking forward to that.
Yeah. I'm kind of just, I want to see what Blackout's like.
Yeah, I'm trying to picture that in my head, and it just does not sound like it works at all.
Oh, I think it could definitely work.
I saw the Music Rex there, and I'm like, fuck.
We all forgot to listen to Music Rex, so next episode, sorry guys.
I didn't.
That exact moment was like when you forget your assignment at home. That's what that felt like. So Black Ops 4 has no campaign. Multiplayer looks okay. Blackout mode looks interesting because that's a combination of everything to ever exist in the Black Ops universe. And zombies looks all right. Anything else we have to say about that before we talk about Lando being a pan?
I think Blackout mode is going to be really ass because the time to kill in Call of Duty is so little. Like,
oh, yeah, true.
I can't imagine long-range combat battle royale.
Yeah, it's too easy.
Like, they're gonna have to fuck with how fast it is to die or some shit. Like, you're gonna have to have like the strength of like a recruit player on campaign mode.
It's Treyarch. I have a lot more faith in Treyarch than like Infinity War.
Yeah, in truth, they could probably make up like a bunch of shit with like shields or some shit.
Yeah, they have shields.
They could probably compare it to like the Halo time to kill or something.
There's
shit.
Actually med kits. Like, there's healing now in COD.
Oh, damn.
The multiplayer. So, like, there's definitely healing. I can't wait to build in Blackout mode.
I don't think you're going to be able to build.
Me, Brandon, and Henry were playing fucking, like, Black Ops 1 on, like, just the PC. And, like, we kept, like, trying to build because we'd all been playing Fortnite nonstop.
I fucking miss the old CODs. Like,
I know, they're so fun.
They're so much better than new CODs. I don't know, like, where they fucking went wrong, but, like, Black Ops 1 is so much better than 3.
Like, I don't know that they're, like, objectively, like, worse. It's just I feel like they got way more samey, like, movement-wise. Like, Black Ops 3 and Infinite Warfare, I genuinely cannot distinguish.
When I played Black Ops 1 again, I felt like it just felt better. Like, it just felt better all around. In World War 2 was so fucking close to being, like, the old CODs, but it just felt like it was missing something, and, like, Black Ops 1 had that thing it was missing, you know? So it's like, I don't know. They fuck something up along the way.
I think that the thing it's missing is being on Xbox 360.
To be honest, there's just
something so magical about those absolutely ass quality party chats, Brandon.
Dude, it was okay. It was amazing running into kids in that game because they just fucking scream, and it was just like it sounded.
It was just
so
distorted.
Ass.
You could barely understand what they were saying.
Yeah,
like
fuck
just talk
you.
Like just chatting shit with your friends on fucking like Xbox Live parties and like 6v6s. It was great. I miss like the crazy ass 1v1s you could do in Black Ops 2, like just fucking with the game mode settings and all that.
Yeah, I feel sorry for PlayStation players. They never got to experience Xbox Live. Yeah, now PS4 is like 10 times better than the fucking Xbox One. So I guess they win.
They don't have any backwards compatibility, though, do they? So they can't play, like, Black Ops 2 on the PS4?
No, they kind of do, but they kind of don't. It's called, like, PlayStation Now, and it's,
yeah,
like,
I know about that, but I don't know if they have, like, Call of Duty on it.
I don't know if they... Well, isn't Black Ops 2 on the PS4?
No, Black Ops 3 is.
Are you sure?
Black Ops 2 is not on PS4 as
far
as I'm aware.
Black Ops 2, I don't think it is either.
It's on, like, it's backwards compatible on Xbox One, I'm pretty sure. I know the original Black Ops is backwards compatible on Xbox One.
Okay, yeah, you're right, isn't it? It was Black Ops 3 that was on the PS4, and, like, the port for the fucking Xbox 360 and PS3 was ass.
Yeah, it didn't have a campaign, but it did have a free copy of Black Ops.
Yeah, so, I mean, I don't know. Fucking, I miss the old CODs.
Can we like buy a pre-owned Xbox actually, never mind. I'll say it after the cast.
Okay. Quite give us a segue. Go.
Lando Calrissian. He's apparently pansexual according to one of the fucking screenwriters, but it doesn't ever show up in frame, so who cares?
Yeah, and I also want to point out one of the article titles that came out of this that has now been changed. Make Star Wars gay, you cowards. And then that title has now been changed to Star Wars Lando. Lando's pansexuality means nothing if it's not in the film. So, much more appropriate title, to be fair.
Yeah, honestly, but, like, I think, like, I'm fine with, like, I'm all for characters being gay and shit, but, like, in, like, pansexual or bisexual or whatever you want to make them. But, like, if you're just gonna say it just to try and get extra brownie points, like J.K. Rowling did, and not even show it on screen, like, I like, don't expect me to care.
Yeah, it really doesn't matter in the plot, at least from our knowledge at the moment.
Yeah. Gets, like, I don't remember, I forgot where it was mentioned, but was it, like, one of the directors of, like, a fucking Solo that said, like, there's room for a potential Lando Calrissian Solo film? If it shows up in that film, if it happens, then I guess it would mean something, but so far it's just kind of fodder. It's not really anything meaningful.
Yeah, it's just kind of there.
Yeah, it's just trying to, like, it's trying to get brownie points after the fact instead of incorporating it into your story meaningfully.
That's,
like,
the best way to do it, because it's less work.
It's like, I get the credit without doing the work.
You know what, and I find free advertising really weird? The screenwriter said this about Lando, but the screenwriter never came up with Lando in the first place. George Lucas wrote that character. So technically, it's up to him whether or not Lando should be gay or not, or banned.
I remember someone saying, like, a pretty good point, like, characters being pansexual in space should be, like, a pretty fucking common thing. Because, like, imagine all the weird genitals in aliens.
That's what
Lando
I said!
Fucks Jar Jar Binks confirmed!
You stole my damn joke.
I did,
Brandon,
say a joke.
I don't know how well you could hear that over Diesel saying, that's what I said, but can you please repeat your joke?
Lando fucks Jar Jar Binks confirmed.
How old is Jar Jar Binks by now, like, in the fucking Star Wars universe?
I don't know.
By Return of the Jedi.
I want to see Jar Jar Binks in the Solo movie.
Stop.
Did you know that, like, at the end of, like, you know, like, the 90s edit of, like, all the original trilogy? Like, at the end scene, like, at Return of the Jedi, like, they have the celebration where, like, on all the different planets, and then, like, the original, it was only on Endor, and then at the end, like, it goes to, like, other planets, like Coruscant and Naboo, but, like, in the fucking Naboo scene, you can hear Jar Jar.
Oh, Jar Jar would totally be dead.
Jar Jar's in Jar Jar's in episode 6, canonically.
But he should be dead.
I agree, but
he could just be really old.
They only lived to 65. Would that mean he's dead?
You looked up how long Gungans live?
I looked up how old is Jar Jar Binks, and it came up with the age span.
Well, I think Gungans can be significantly older if we're talking about the canon of Star Wars here, but I'm not really sure. I'm not well-versed in Naboo nature.
This is on a website called Science Fiction and Fantasy, and it looks kind of janky, so...
they're probably telling the truth. I don't know.
Most sites quote the lifespan of a Gungan at 65 years average.
Okay, so
maybe they just pop out the womb fully grown, and, like, Jar Jar was only 5, so, like, he was 30 in Return of the Jedi.
It would explain a lot of his character. Have you guys seen the conspiracy theories about making that George Lucas wanted to make Jar Jar Binks, like, some really evil character?
Yeah, like, how, like, he's supposed to be the dark side equivalent of Yoda.
Yeah.
And then, like, the poor reception, like, they had to fucking scrap him or some shit.
I would have loved, like, to see that, though. Like,
that would have been great. Like, it would have been such a good juxtaposition, like, how Yoda was kind of, like, a goofy kind of character in episode 5, kind of like how Jar Jar was in episode 1, just way less entertaining. Like, if he was shown to be, like, that kind of serious type of mean, that would have been pretty cool.
Yeah, Jar Jar Binks becomes, like, Darth Vader.
Also, this ad showed up on my Twitter timeline just now, but you know how Teen Titans Go is getting a movie?
Yes.
It is?
Yeah, it is. Well, there's like this fucking ad, and it's Deathstroke talking, like animated Teen Titans Go Deathstroke talking about Deadpool. Like, what the fuck is happening?
That doesn't really surprise me.
But it's Teen Titans Go, a fucking kid show talking about R-rated Deadpool.
Oh, that's true, actually.
And it's crossing like DC Universe talking about fucking Marvel in an ad. What the hell is happening?
They probably pay them a lot. Well, does Disney own Cartoon Network?
No.
Oh.
I don't know how it works.
That's just, I don't either. That's just mind-boggling. Like,
Have you guys seen like the pictures of all the Deadpool fucking cover art at Walmart? Because
yes, it's so fucking good.
That's good fucking marketing right there.
I wish I was in this movie.
I'm seeing Deadpool Tuesday.
I'm seeing it today.
So. I need to see it. Like soon.
See it before we record the next episode so we can talk about it the next episode.
Yeah, we can do what we did with Infinity War.
Okay.
Yeah.
Can we talk about Lando being gay? I have a lot of feelings about this.
Okay, go.
Okay, so I tweeted this out, but it was like, you know, there's no problem with Lando being gay. Like we said, in space, alien genitals are alien genitals, not people genitals. So, like, a lot of people should be pan in the Star Wars universe. Because technically, if we're going by the definition of pan, we should include species in there. If aliens are...
Yeah.
I'm just talking about it in the canon of Star Wars.
I know.
Yeah, it's complete...
I know.
It's an appropriate thing to think, okay? You know, I said we shouldn't be writing gay characters, you know, to have a gay character or anything like that. We should be writing good characters who happen to be gay. Because you know how you get people who are bigots to stop being bigots? Get them to relate to people who are like that. So, don't write the, hey, like, gay character. Write a good character who happens to be gay. So, that's how I feel about the Lando thing. You know, I've never been one for representation as a Hispanic male, especially being Puerto Rican. It's always the Mexicans who get movies. I never get movies. It was like, the closest thing for us was like Coco or The Book of Life. And it's like, those are about Mexican people. But yeah, we never get represented. So, okay, like,
I mean,
come on.
It's even worse for Asians.
You guys got Jackie Chan.
Wow, so much. We have crazy rich Asians. That's what we have. That's our Black Panther.
You have rice gum.
Oof.
Okay, I'm about to leave this podcast.
We could use an Asian. Is there an Asian Avenger or MCU?
No, there's no Asian superheroes. There's fucking like Mantis. Really? There you go.
Damn, Mantis.
Yeah, no, literally.
Oh
not.
Yeah, she's Asian.
I think there was like an Asian Superman at some point, but he's DC, and I don't want a DC superhero.
Damn,
nobody wants a DC.
No,
superhero.
Apparently they were gonna add a Muslim superhero to the MCU.
Oh
before
yeah,
they were gonna add
Miss Marvel was fucking Miss Marvel. She's,
What about my Asian homies? Wait. Hook us up with an Asian superhero if you're gonna be.
I don't think there's any Asian superheroes that are like mainstream.
Really,
just
it comes
make
down
a
to
character
who complains
Asian.
The most. It really comes down to who complains the most.
It is.
We listen, Brandon. I'm sure more of us would complain if there were more of us.
Oof.
There's so many Chinese people though. Why aren't they like?
They're
they
all
don't
in
have
one
access
place.
To the internet.
There's a bunch of Chinese people, but they're not in America. And the ones that
the
are
the Chinese
like,
film market
place.
Is huge.
Like yeah, in China.
That's like saying the Bollywood film market's huge.
Yeah, no. Like, that's why they keep making movies that happen in Hong Kong and shit, so that way Chinese people go see it.
But they make those in, like, Chinese filmmakers make those, Diesel.
No, like, Transformers keeps having finales to their movies in China purposefully sell tickets in China.
Bro, I don't think Transformers is the best example to use.
Yeah, but they actually really like Transformers over there.
What the fuck? What's happening?
No,
but Chinese Americans.
But Brandon's right. It totally does come down to who complains the most.
Yeah.
I'm like, where's the Hispanic superhero? Where's Captain Juan Ortega Ortiz.
You're not being specific enough.
Bro,
you
got
say
fucking
Puerto
Blue
Rican.
Beetle. Blue Beetle's dope as hell.
I didn't even know Blue Beetle was Hispanic. Or actually, yeah, I did. I thought he was Indian.
Who's Blue Beetle?
Blue Beetle's fucking... Oh, he's great. I fucking love
he's
Blue Beetle.
He's a DC superhero.
Oh, no wonder I don't know who he is.
Brandon is so uncultured.
Doesn't listen to music, doesn't know what superheroes are.
Brandon didn't Marvel watch an anime until he watched One Punch Man with Anna.
She just had it on to my right, and I just started watching.
That's a great anime, but you need to watch anime.
I still haven't watched One Punch Man, TBH.
I want to watch John Wick 2. That's what I want to watch.
That's my favorite anime.
That's my kind of anime.
John Wick 2 is the best anime.
Like, I call this the Stardust Crusaders of podcasts, but you're not going to get that joke because you've never watched JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, Brandon.
I haven't watched it either, to be fair.
Oh, exactly, you're so you're fucking dumb.
Uh-huh, yeah.
I've heard good things.
JoJo's Bizarre Adventure is so good. You need to watch
it. Right now, I'm just waiting for Boku no Hero to get the end of the season so I can binge watch all three over again.
Yeah, same.
Yeah, same. Same, guys.
Do you know what Boku no Hero is?
Yeah, same.
Brandon, you have to watch... Brandon, Deja, we should watch it together and make Brandon watch it with us, okay?
Yeah, we totally should. That'd be great. Yeah. That'd be so cute.
Just podcast family podcast bonding time.
No, we shouldn't watch Boku no Hero. We should watch Boku no Pico.
Fuck you, Diesel. We're trying to get him to like anime, not never want to open the internet again. God, why? That's like the stereotypical like gross anime to jump to. Shut up.
Yeah, it is. I mean, like in general, there are a lot of traps these days, though. So who knows? There might be a trap in Boku no Hero. You know.
Goodbye.
I'm just Diesel, saying.
You like traps?
No, traps aren't gay, but like they are gay. I don't know what to pick. There's a meme.
If you think a trap is a female. And you are attracted to the trap because you think they're female, it's not gay. But if you know they're a trap, then it's gay.
Brandon, I think you're just trying to hide the fact you're gay. That's all I'm hearing.
Hey, I told you, don't bring yourself on the podcast.
Okay. This is a post-show discussion.
On to the next topic!
move on!
Okay, let's divulge into the Diesel topics, the best topics.
Yeah, the best topics are the least organized and the least flushed out.
Somebody didn't start organizing them until 10 minutes before recording.
Hold on.
I told Quite before you joined the call on your PC that we were going to bully you because of the lack of topics you had.
Yup.
Okay, well, like, yup. These are great topics regardless of that.
Yeah, I love weird Netflix movies. Fantastic topic.
Because I totally watched them. I totally
you guys
watched
haven't
that
watched
movie
weird
with
Netflix
Adam Sandler
movies?
Where he pretends to die.
No, actually, I don't. Because I go to Netflix and I'm like, I don't like any of this shit. And I don't watch it.
God. So uncultured, Brandon.
Oh, don't watch Netflix. Uncultured swine.
Listen, most people aren't cultured as far as Netflix, like the fucking obscure shit at the bottom of the Netflix pile goes.
Yeah.
I'm certainly not.
No, but didn't we watch Birdemic, Brandon? I feel like we did. Was it you and I that watched that?
That might have been you and Erling. I don't remember watching this.
Yeah, oh man, that was a long time ago. Birdemic's great. It's not on Netflix.
I did not watch this, but it has a 1 out of 10, and now I want to watch it.
I saw the JonTron video about it. Does that count?
Yeah, good enough. It's really funny.
I want to watch this now. I want to watch really this funny. Now. Is this on Netflix?
Probably not.
Oh.
There's also The Room, which is another classic good bad movie. Like, it is so bad. There's a 7-minute long sex
bad,
scene
bad,
at the beginning
good.
Of that movie, and I watched it with my bros from college. We're all just sitting in this dark room watching Tommy Wiseau dick down this girl. It's very uncomfortable.
Good, I'm glad.
Oh, man.
When you get with your college bros and watch porn.
Yeah.
You ever just sitting down with your group of friends and you're just like watching porn together and you're just like rating it?
I mean,
like,
you're not even
getting one up. You're literally just like looking at it like, huh.
We've been like weirded out and we're like, let's look at weird porn. And then we'll just like look at it and we're like, this is weird. But it's not like
we basically do that, but it's like with Rule 34.
Yeah.
Wait, what? Wait, no, wait, what?
We'll be in call and we'll be talking about something like Vore or some shit.
We'll be in
a bunch of fucking pictures.
We'll be in call.
I don't think I've been here for these discussions.
No,
not
we've done it before.
You have.
Yeah, we'll be like that. Like someone will be like, oh, that shit's nasty. Then someone will just keep sending more in the chat. Like,
oh yeah.
Yeah. A couple days ago? I was putting like inflation porn in like the group chat.
Yeah.
Just because it was funny, but. Last night, I watched a really bad Netflix movie called Officer Down, spelt with an E, right? So, yeah, of course. I knew Brandon was going to laugh at that.
That's why it's spelt wrong.
Yeah. Yeah, I didn't spell it wrong.
I thought it was a typo.
No, it was not a typo. And you left the typo there?
Yeah, because I'm just like, it's Diesel's topic list, not mine. I don't give a
okay,
shit.
Okay. Yeah, but have you ever seen Dread?
No.
No.
Oh my god. You guys need to see that movie too. That's a really good movie.
Two uncultured people!
First of all, Dread is genuinely a good movie. Okay? It's an R-rated superhero movie. But
well, I'm watching Deadpool 2 today. Like, what
yeah,
does it matter?
I'm watching Deadpool Tuesday.
Got I already watched Logan. I don't need to watch anymore, dude.
Oh my god. Anyway, it's like Judge Dredd mixed with Frankenstein's monster.
Judge Judy.
It's you're the worst.
Fucking Diesel. Totally unrelated to this, but have you watched Memento?
No, I have not.
Have you guys watched Uncultured. Infinity War?
Uncultured. No, I haven't. I haven't watched it. But no, watch Memento, bro. It's good.
I will watch it.
It was really good. They're good. That's our obligatory Mac mention for this episode. So
there we go. But yeah, okay. So Officer Down is based on this comic book of this cop who can't die, and he's like basically Frankenstein's monster. It was directed by one of the members of Slipknot, which should tell you how this movie is going to be. But at one point in the movie, this black ninja who wears Gucci and is dubbed out of sync on purpose, goes to an old folks home with a group of ninjas dressed in Gucci, murders everyone, and then Officer Down drives his truck through the wall, uses a battering ram with one hand to beat the shit out of all the ninjas dressed in Gucci.
Wait, is this a fucking, like, Good It's Bad movie?
Is this on Netflix?
Yeah, this is on Netflix.
I want to watch this.
Yeah, is this a So Good It's Bad movie, though?
It is. It is so strange. At one point, Officer Down walks into a church and shoots all these nuns in the face and their heads explode.
Nice.
And it was the weirdest thing. But I completely lost my shit when this guy was, like, beating up all these ninjas. And he was just like, you have the right to remain silent. And then he's like, you have the right to remain silent, motherfucker. And I'm just like, this movie is absolutely garbage. Oh my god.
Why is there an E in Down?
Because it's like, it's supposed to be like Officer Down. Like, you know, like an officer got shot, like they're down. But every time he gets down, he gets back up. Like, it's a play on words.
Oh. Yeah. I thought it was like, oh, copyright. we couldn't do Officer Down with no E.
The movie, like, literally ends without resolving half of its plot lines, too. Which I'm just like, what the fuck? Why'd you introduce that? Like, the three main bad guys of the movie are a wolf man, a cheetah lady, and a vulture guy. And
sounds like Batman.
Yeah, but they're like actual animals,
so
which
Batman.
Is weird. No, it's not like Batman because
Man Bat.
They're like guy who comes to them to tell them what's happening, like in the movie, is dressed in a gimp suit and he has a ball gag, and they call him Ballmaster.
Imagine if Batman was going against Catgirl, and Catgirl was like literally just a fucking cat.
Catwoman, get it right, Brandon.
Oh, sorry.
Cat girl.
Is it cat woman or cat girl?
It's cat woman.
We're going with cat girl.
Cat girl.
No, we're not. We're not going with that.
Diesel likes cat girls.
No. Okay. So first of all, cat girls do not make you a furry. Okay.
That's something a furry would say.
Diesel, like, that's literally like fucking like you're just incriminating yourself by opening with that.
I mean, I'm just. Stating the facts.
instead of denying that you like cat girls, it's just like, okay.
No, well,
cat girls do not make you a furry.
They don't, okay? Like, they do not make
they
you
don't.
A furry.
They make you a furry.
No, they don't.
Oh, Diesel, the master of shooting himself in the foot.
Look, there is just something about girls
furries.
With cat ears. Prefer, you know, honestly, you don't really does me in the maid outfits, but you know, that's just me. I'm a heathen.
Furry.
Anyway, I will fuck you
furries
up.
Furries in maid outfits, got it.
Furries in maid outfits or furries and maid outfits?
In. In as in inside.
Well,
yes.
All of my credibility has been ruined.
You had any to begin with?
So Diesel, you want to talk about the royal wedding between you and a cat girl?
Yeah, let's. That's the royal wedding we want to hear about. So I'm gonna hope you guys paid attention to the royal wedding because I put this down
I paid
here
attention
and didn't see anything.
Slightly,
same. I
very
kinda,
slightly.
I looked at. I glanced at it every now and then.
I can't believe Ed Sheeran and some other lady got married. It was a joke there.
Yeah, it was in reality. It was between Prince Harry and Meghan Markle, who is an American actress. Fucking
yeah. And then yeah. Prince Harry, I know that Prince Harry, like, limited the reporting in there by, like, a lot. Like, he let, like, one publication and then, like, two, no, it was, like, one reporter and, like, two publications that were allowed in. And then compared to the last one, it was, like, 40. Last one had, like, 40, so.
I think that's fair. It's his wedding. Like,
I looked into it. Apparently, like, throughout his entire life, he's been trying to limit media attention as much as possible, so.
I get that.
Yeah.
A lot of people said that, like, it was a waste of money and shit, because, like, it's, like, $12 million on, like, a wedding for, like, a monarchy that has no power, but, like, one of the arguments I heard against it was, like, that it brings in a shit ton of money as far as tourism goes, and that, like, whatever they lost on taxes by hosting that wedding and broadcasting it, they made back in droves with, like, the amount of attention it brought.
I could easily see that.
It's like the demand is there, so they supply it.
Yeah, because if you get a bunch of tourists to come to the UK, it's like,
yeah,
they're not just going to spend money just on, like, a hotel and flight. They're going to just buy a bunch of shit. So, I mean, yeah. Is that all we have to say about the royal wedding between Diesel and
I can't believe that the queen's not dead yet. Real talk.
She's not. She's never going to die, I'm convinced.
How old is she?
Immortal.
Like, every time someone says God save the queen, I think, like, it genuinely, like, helps her get a few years.
How old is the queen? Yeah, every time, so it's like she's gonna live forever.
God save the queen, and it's just like she.
Holy shit, Diesel, you're right.
How old is she?
She's 92.
Oh my god.
No, she's looking pretty good for her age.
She's here to stay. She's like, no one's gonna.
No, I would honestly, I was thinking like 80s. Damn.
Yeah, I was thinking 80s too.
Damn.
You know that Prince Harry invited a bunch of his ex girlfriends to the wedding too.
Really,
bruh?
Yeah.
What a lad. Sounds like something fucking. But it sounds like something Cardi B would do.
What a mad lad. What a
absolute mad lad.
Next Reddit videos, r/madlads.
r/madlads, god.
JK.
Prince Harry's on it, top post.
Honestly, he's probably on there somewhere.
r/Prince Harry, top posts.
Ah, yes. He's such
a
punk.
Is that a subreddit?
It has to. There's got to be a Prince Harry fan page.
Can someone explain to me why they think Prince Harry's hot? I don't think he's that hot.
I haven't gotten a good look at him.
Like, I don't think he's unattractive, but, like, he's not, like, hot.
I can see it with the facial hair. Like, some people are, like, gingers, and, like, that fucking combo with, like, the scruff, I can definitely see it. It's not my type, but I can definitely see it.
Three men rate other men on podcast.
I'm just saying.
Only one of which is attracted to men.
He looks like
Ed Sheeran.
We will
not say who.
The thing is, though, like, I'm not even a man.
He does not look like Ed Sheeran.
He looks like a cheap Ed Sheeran.
I'm not even a man.
Ed Sheeran looks like a cheap Ed Sheeran.
Oh, that's fucked up. That's
Jesus Christ.
That's so mean.
Prince Harry. No, one second. You'll see exactly what I'm talking about.
I gotta ask, what is Rupert Grint been up to nowadays?
Who the fuck is Rupert Grint?
Ron Weasley.
That is Ed Sheeran. And then this is Prince Harry. Are you telling me Prince Harry looks like a cheap Ed Sheeran?
Ed Sheeran looks like Ron Weasley. Yes, yes, those look... God, Ed Sheeran looks like he got punched in the face a little too many times.
God, Diesel, what
the
fuck? No,
Ed Sheeran is a cheap Ed Sheeran.
Okay,
that's Rupert
Ed
Grint.
Sheeran and Ron Weasley are the same person.
No, they're not. They're not that
yes,
close.
They are. They are that close.
No, they're close enough to be like... They're close enough to replace... the kids from Sweet Life and Zack and Cody, but they're not
it's
that
pretty
close.
Fucking similar considering they were actual twins.
Yeah, but when they got older, their facial features changed. They looked like clones when they were younger, but not anymore.
I have no idea what happened at the royal wedding.
Yeah, yet you put it down on your list.
I needed a topic. Give me a break.
10 minutes before record, Diesel's like, you know what? What happened this week? Ah, royal wedding.
I don't get why, like, the wee men were, like, so obsessed with it. I don't get it. I don't get it. The wee men.
God, you say it like it's such a foreign
they
word.
They probably thought it was cute or something.
I don't know. They're like wedding goals. It's like, lady, I can barely afford to feed myself.
Let alone have, like, $1 million+ wedding.
It's like, all right, you keep shooting for a prince. I'm sure there's a lot more out there.
Nigerian princes. They contact me.
They'll hook you up with a real good wedding.
Okay, Diesel, let's talk about your next topic.
Okay, white people baby names.
Okay, what about the white people baby names?
So this was a GQ article called Why Are My Fellow Whites Still So Awful at Naming Children? And in this article, Drew McGarry goes on to talk about how white people are awful at naming their kids.
Did he talk about how his name's retarded?
Apparently he doesn't think it is. But he said this isn't virtue signaling, and it totally is. Also, what makes this great are the names that are listed. So have you ever met anyone named Cairo?
I'm on this list right now. I have not met anybody named Cairo, Case, Cashton, Jackson. I've never met someone with it spelled like that. Ledger, Ridge, Aiden. I've never seen any of these names, like the way they're spelled.
Who the fuck spells Aiden like that? What is this?
Aiden.
Aiden.
That's how it's spelled.
Like, this reminds me of the GQ article where, like, they fucking, like, named PewDiePie, like, one of the worst-dressed men of fucking, like, 2017. And, like, they said, checkered was so lat, like, 2015, and it's because they used a photo from 2015.
Dude, this dude must have, like, looked up the least, like, least common names and just fucking plucked them from a list. And it was like,
no, he went to the Social Security baby name database. So he went to the official source for baby names and picked out these names for being stupid. And then also assumes that everyone with these names is white, which is also hilarious.
I can see some foreign people named Cairo.
Yeah, I could
too. Cairo doesn't even sound that bad.
You know King of Kazoos? Like, his name's Kai.
Yeah,
like,
Kai's not bad.
That? Yeah, is it short for that?
I don't know. Maybe.
Maybe. But then, like, Jackson. Like, I've met people who are black named Jackson with two X's.
I've never met anybody named Jackson with two X's.
I've never met anybody named Jackson, period.
Really?
Then again, I've met very few people from the walls of this box.
I've met maybe four.
It's just you guys. It's just you guys.
Oh.
I'd never name my kids any of these things. Like,
cheap names. Diesel, you're also not white.
Oh, excuse me. Yeah, I gotta name my kids.
No, like,
kid
but like the target of this article is supposed to be white people.
True.
So,
facts.
Like, I don't know.
I was gonna name
again,
my daughter Dora the Explorer.
I don't know what white people he's thinking about, because, like, again, like,
fucking Dora the Explorer.
Yeah, my son's name is gonna be Diego. I'm gonna have a dog called Boots.
Why not just get a monkey?
Where am I gonna get a monkey?
You can get monkeys.
Yeah, I'm not.
Dude, did I ever tell you about how there were these fucking monkeys in the airport when I was flying to PAX?
There were monkeys in the airport.
How'd you fly the PAX when you were in a box?
We've been over this. You guys came to visit my box. It's a very.
But
it can be a very big
fly?
Box, but it can be a very big box if I need it to be.
We met in the middle. We met in New Jersey. Nobody wants to go there.
What about the monkeys in your box?
But fucking, like, this one lady had just fucking monkeys, like, and she was trying to bring them through customs, and, like, one of the people was like, are you sure those fucking clear customs or some shit? Because, like, she had, like, five monkeys in cages and shit.
Why did she have monkeys? I wonder what she was going
I to. Don't know.
Your pet monkeys. You can own monkeys.
Yeah, can.
Like, you can have them as pets.
I think that's an awful idea. They're going to throw poop at you and stuff.
Yeah, exactly. Like, they actually do that. They actually will throw shit at your face. So, I don't know why you own a monkey.
That's awful.
I saw someone on Twitter with a lemur.
I'd get a lemur. That sounds cool.
They hop around a lot.
Zoom tight, buddy.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
Okay, but, enough of talking about Cairo. Let's talk about your dating sim, Diesel.
Okay, so they're trying to get dating simulators removed from Steam, and I am not okay with this.
Oh, wait. It's not just like one game that's been removed. They're trying to get all of them removed?
Anything pornographic.
Anything pornographic. So,
why does it matter?
A game called Kama Sutra, Tropical Liquor, Relord 1, Kindred Spirits on the Roof, Battle Girls, Galaxy Girls, Roommates, Sakura Sadist.
These are all animes.
Deep Space Waifu, which is an amazing name.
Of course you think so.
Coming Out on Top, another amazing name. Forest Fortress is a bad name. But then there's also Honey Pop on there. Which Honey Pop is a great game.
Okay. I thought they were just going to remove one, and it was going to be, like, some retarded reason, but, like, that's kind of dumb. Why remove them? Just mark them as, like, nudity. Like, put a big marker there. Like, there's already age restrictions for when you go to game pages, you know?
Apparently, like, organizations are, like, purposely, like, campaigning against them.
That doesn't surprise me.
Like, I don't know exactly the specifics, but I heard they might be facing some pressure from PayPal to do so. I'm not exactly sure why. It's just
I know why. Doesn't allow them. PayPal does not allow you to purchase anything that's pornographic.
Oh.
So I see where they're pressuring it. They also don't let you to purchase weapons, which is pretty fucking obvious, but like they're like under the same rule.
I mean, I guess these are like barely pornographic. I mean, they're kind of they're kind of racy.
I mean, by this logic, like if I were Steam, I'd just be like, okay, PayPal, you don't want us to use the thing. We won't let them purchase with PayPal for games that contain nudity. Plain and simple.
It's like Far Cry 3 though. Can't buy that because it's got tits in it.
Well, I mean, like. Obviously it would be like mainly the dating some things, and there'd be like there'd obviously be outliers. It would be a double standard to some extent. So I mean
Well, like PayPal didn't do this because out of nowhere, like they're doing it because they're feeling
PayPal
pressure
directly. I think it was like
feeling pressure from
I think the National Sexual Exploitation League
or
something.
Like some shit with Me Too, apparently.
National Sexual Exploitation League. That sounds like a shitty cartoon.
Yeah, but they're like, oh, people play Honey Pop and then will enact real world sexual exploitation and violence on women. So this is the only solution.
Happens.
Like they said that this was the only solution is to just get rid of the games, which is hilarious. But no, that's not the case.
Okay,
but yeah, they want to remove my waifus from Steam.
I don't think they'll remove them, especially Honey Pop.
They already have.
They remove Honey Pop?
No.
Pretty sure.
So Steam's not gonna remove Honey Pop. Just Honey Pop specifically. I don't know about the other ones.
Yeah, because Honey
Pop
did well.
This is an excruciatingly long article.
Yeah, Honey Pop did well. Why would they remove Honey Pop? Oh, speaking of Steam games, totally off topic. Diesel, we have to play World Adrift soon. They had another update.
You guys finished The Way Out yet?
No.
No.
God damn it, Diesel!
Sorry.
I keep forgetting about that. We're finishing it tonight. You understand?
You mentioned it every podcast, and you never fucking play it.
I know.
We're finishing it tonight. You understand me?
Dude, he's got a video to make.
He has two videos to make.
I don't have time tonight.
Damn it. Damn it, Diesel.
There you
Damn
go.
It.
You know, I could be making a video right now, but instead I'm talking to you more on some podcast.
Oh, wow. It's almost like you're recording a podcast. Wow.
Yeah.
This whole other obligation that you have.
I'm sorry. I didn't know we were recording this early.
We told you last night.
I came and called last night and it was like, okay, does 2 p.m. EST work? And then Quite's like, yeah. And then Diesel's like, yeah. And I'm like, okay, gonna go back
to
editing.
I didn't know it was Sunday.
But
I said tomorrow.
I didn't remember. When did we have this conversation? Yesterday?
Yesterday!
Literally last night!
I don't remember having this conversation yesterday.
Oh my god.
You left in the middle to figure out how you... Never mind.
Diesel.
I don't remember. I don't remember!
The caffeine's gone to your head.
God, I did just have a monster to wake up. It's a bad time. I'm just really sad that they're taking away my waifus. I feel a sudden urge in my body to go play Honey Pop right now.
Okay, before you go play Honey Pop, introduce us to this Thundercat thing.
Okay, so Thundercats is being rebooted, and everybody is really upset.
Yeah, I saw that. Is it good? Because didn't they opt for like the super cheap like animation style that Steven Universe has?
It's not like a cheap animation style. It's what they call the CalArts art style. So
it's just very goofy.
Yeah, people who go to CalArts all learn this style and they all just make a cartoon in this style. So it's like the jelly bean
like,
sausage.
I saw somewhere that it was cheap.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't know how accurate that is.
Yeah, I don't know how accurate that is.
I mean, I could see it being I could see it being cheap if everyone who goes to that specific school learns it, because then there's more of them, which lowers the cost of their work because there's more of an abundance.
Yeah.
I don't know why everybody's copying the same art style for their cartoons.
But it seems like there's just like a pretty general outrage about it, because it seems kind of like it's sort of like the same Teen Titans Go effect. Where it's like a lighthearted, very goofy.
Yeah, I'm looking at the original
otherwise
Thundercats.
Like, balanced
it looks nothing
series.
Fucking like it.
The 80s Thundercats is like super masculine, and then the reboot from like a couple of years ago is like really well done, like anime esque. And then this is Steven Universe, like chibi comedy style.
Damn,
it'll be good.
That has like a that's like a. Really fucking god, that's a lot of dislikes.
I mean, like, I don't really mind reboots as long as the product can stand on its own. You know, for all Teen Titans Go is worth, it really stands on its own as its own show. You know, like, it's a funny comedy show, and it works. It's obviously different from the original Teen Titans, and I get that, and I like the original Teen Titans. But, you know, maybe I'm not in the mood for original Teen Titans, and I'll watch Teen Titans Go instead. Because it's like a funny show. Like, there are actually genuinely, like, funny bits in it, and they're pretty self-aware about how people feel about the show, too.
Yeah, like, they had fucking, like, a crossover Young Justice episode, where, like, they had a Young Justice crossover episode where, like, they poked fun at themselves so much.
Yeah, and I'm they've done, like, crossovers like with the original Teen Titans art style. And then,
yeah, I'm pretty
what's
sure, like,
show?
They fucking, like, featured joke videos of, like, people who have made videos on YouTube saying that Teen Titans Go sucks. And
they
put,
have,
like, little homages to that in the background.
A lot of but people don't like this.
I don't hate the people behind Teen Titans Go. I'm just not a big fan of the show.
Yeah, I'm not, like, it. A huge fan. Like, I think Amazing World of Gumball is, like, a great example of art direction.
I need to,
and
like,
all that.
Watch that yeah. show because, like, I don't watch it because I don't really watch TV. Yeah, Gumball's, like, really fucking funny. Like, it
yeah,
has
it
some
is,
really
like,
funny
genuinely.
Parts. Like, is it on
I think
Hulu?
It's really pretty to look at, too.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, the animation is genuinely good. Like, the mix of that and, like, fucking real-life rotoscoping and shit.
Amazing really cool. World of Gumball is on Hulu. Hell yeah.
There you go.
Can you screen share that?
But,
screen share my Hulu.
Fuck, I can't remember what I was going to say. Oh, what was another... I'm trying to think of another reboot that, like, worked well, and it was... It's on the tip of my tongue. It's not Teen Titans... Well, I know it's Teen Titans Go is one of them. The Powerpuff remake... was awful. That's because they tried to appeal to the youngins.
They used Me Gusta memes.
No Me Gusta. Oh,
no Me Gusta.
Awful.
No Me Gusta. Despacito. Madame Jeff.
Wait a second. How much of an hour does the Amazing World of Gumball take up on fucking Cartoon Network? Does it take up 30 minutes?
I don't know.
Yeah.
18 minutes of the 30 minutes are ads.
There you go.
Because each of them are 12 minute episodes.
Oh, no. It's two, like, 12 minute episodes, I think.
Yeah, it's two 12
minute
episodes.
Okay. Yeah. I was about to say, 18. Like, I looked up advertisement rates on TV. It is pretty fucking high, but, like, I didn't think it was that high.
I think people should be more upset with Thundercats, not for being, like, a reboot that's not original to the, like, that's not faithful to the original art style, but more or less that it's another comedy cartoon when we're already super oversaturated with comedy cartoons.
I mean, like, it just works, so they're using it while it works.
Yeah, I mean, I miss the days of, like, action cartoons. I think we were really lacking in those, but those don't really work as well, just apparently, allegedly. I'm not from the animation industry, of course, but from what I've heard on it's an animation. It's kind of like an animation cartoon podcast, the Pizza Party podcast. We should slide into those guys' DMs. But they
don't
were talking
plug
the about
podcast. We need it. We can't lose viewers, Diesel.
Well, our podcast is 100 times better because we record frequently and we don't skip uploads.
So okay, you just said we need to sign the DMs, and then you say our podcast is better.
I'm just you should. We should do diss tracks on other podcasts.
No, we should do diss podcasts on other podcasts. A whole
Can
hour.
Can we do a Minecraft Let's
a
Play?
We'll do a Minecraft Let's Play at 100k. No promises.
Yay!
at 100k. No. We'll have a whole hour of just pointing out flaws in other podcasts.
Oh my god.
Can we point out flaws in our podcast? I feel like self-deprecation is the way of our
us. Well,
we're unorganized.
We're unorganized. We don't know how to segue. We keep talking about pictures that the audience can't see.
I feel like every podcast does that, though. Like Pictionary? Hell yeah.
I feel like it.
I think every podcast is mostly bad at segues, too. Especially when they're trying to, like, lead into sponsors. Like, they'll just pick up keywords. Like, it's like, hey, Diesel, what time is it? And then it's like, they go into, like, hey, here's our sponsor, a watch. Like, they do that kind of shit. So, we're not that bad.
I don't know about that.
We're not that bad. On a scale of, like, segueing, we're probably, like, 5 out of 10.
The only issue, like, the Pictionary thing, the only reason it's an issue is because we keep fucking addressing it. Other podcasts do it, too, but they don't make mention of it. But we make mention of it, and then people are like,
who
why aren't you showing us
who
pictures?
Who made the first mention of Pictionary? Whoever did that, it's their fault.
I think it's funny.
Yeah. But, like, who made the first mention of Pictionary? Because whoever did that, it's your fault.
Yeah, it was
Diesel,
me.
It's your fault.
I'm sorry, I started that meme. Can we talk about the Loudmouth fan account that follows all of us?
Wait, okay, I feel like if we're going to talk about that, we need to dedicate more time to it and not just the very tacking on at the end of a podcast.
No, tacking on the end, on the true fans, we'll get this far.
Only the true fans. I have a feeling they'll listen all the way through to hear this, though. which I don't know who runs the account, but it's really weird.
You're funny. Yeah.
We fucking love you. Keep up what you're doing. It's good work. You're
every time I tweet, they like have a picture of me like twirling my face and like me base boosted, like deep fried. Like
the thing is with them though, like they mostly tweet pictures of Diesel, right? But like sometimes they tweet pictures of me, and then they never tweet pictures of Brandon.
So we know who their favorite is.
It's like apparently they like us more. I guess it's because we show our face on camera still. Yeah. Brandon's too scared.
Yeah, too
Brandon's
scared. Brandon's
a recluse. Oh wait, no. Brandon, they tweeted this picture of you. I was wrong.
Great.
Here's one of you. This is the first one of them tweeting you that I've seen. I'm gonna see if I can find
it. It was on your tweet.
Yeah. You fucking replied to me with that edit of me laughing like a tarantula or some shit.
That was in my video. So like I was editing your character on it to make it funny, and like I just kept rewatching. I'm like, this is fucking hilarious. So I just posted it on Twitter.
I'm just really glad I had that like that clip on hand of you getting mad at me for calling you fat. Like, cause like that's the perfect response. Okay, there's just so much Diesel in here.
I know, the account is full of pictures of me, and I'm like, oh, this is very odd.
They were really an OG at, too.
Yeah, they were originally like a FPS Diesel fan account.
We should follow them with the official Twitter, please.
I don't know about that. I don't like them that much.
The pictures are so weird.
He's got a fucking eye for that shit. You gotta give him that.
God,
his job is a spam us.
I do appreciate it. Like, they never miss a beat.
Wubba lubba dub dub.
Okay, for the audio listeners, Quite just posted a picture of Diesel with a really big nose.
No, Diesel posted that.
Yeah, oh, Diesel posted that.
Diesel posted a picture of himself with a really big nose.
Thank you. I know my nose is big. God, our podcast is best podcast. Loudmouse fans are the loudest fans, the bestest fans.
That's good. I like that.
You're only a true Loudmouth fan if you go into a public space and yell, "I love Loudmouse."
If one of you did that, I don't know what we'd do. But we'd
like
it.
We could retweet it.
Obviously we retweet that. Go into a Starbucks, just yell, "I love Loudmouse."
No,
don't get kicked out of anywhere though. Don't get kicked out.
Even better in your college or high school library or middle school library.
Oh my God, Brandon, stop! You're turning into Jake Paul.
I do not condone of this behavior, but I'd like to see it.
Right? I'm gonna encourage you guys absolutely not to do this. Go to your parents. All right.
Well, since you guys are being both neither and not agreeing, I am going to say, do it. I am encouraging it 100%.
I'm gonna say go up to your friends and or your family and tell them to subscribe to Loudmouse. There you go.
No, that is like so fucking easy because like the family already probably knows they're weird. Like, if you're in a public place, like then everyone knows you're weird.
We're telling you to be a public nuisance for a podcast to just fulfill our egos.
Try not to get
in
trouble.
Don't get caught.
Please.
Don't get caught.
Try not to get in trouble. We really appreciate you not ruining education for us.
I was about to say something really bad.
What is going to happen to them if they go into a library and just yell something stupid? Like,
well, if they get caught? If they get caught,
probably get kicked out.
If they get caught, they'll probably be brought to like the office, and then they'll just be like, "Why'd you scream? Subscribe to Loudmouse in the library." And then the dude will probably either be like, "I want to," or "They told me into the podcast," which I didn't tell you to do that, by the way. I just said I would enjoy it. And now probably there's probably some superintendent from a school watching this right now. Like, these people are a nuisance to our education system.
I don't think we qualify as like good role models anyway. Like, I am horribly offensive in every sense of the word.
Yeah, quite a hoodie.
I am deliberately offensive occasionally for the sake of comedy. Like, I have ideas I want people to agree with me on. But I am in no way a role model, so I don't think I am. Just to cover my own ass there we go.
But to be clear, I would enjoy if you did scream in a library, subscribe to Loudmouth. Just to be clear. But don't do it.
Jesus Christ.
The power we have is just being used for evil.
Someone probably is not going to do that, let's be real.
Someone's going to
do it. I can see someone screaming in public, but not in a library.
Not in a library, yeah.
Yeah, don't do it in a library.
Don't do it in a library. You can go to a Starbucks and do it, though.
No, because if he does it in the library, we're more likely to hear because everyone's quiet.
No shit. I mean, a Starbucks ain't a loud venue either.
It depends.
It depends. It oh, excuse me. You live in California where everything is loud.
Yeah.
Mouth.
Oof.
Everything's a loud mouth.
Where everything's a loud mouth. I remember when this was a subject topic about Thundercats.
From that, I think it's probably a good place to end it. Anybody want to outro?
No, Diesel's outroing. Diesel, go.
Diesel's outroing. I can you not do that to me?
What?
I don't want you to just be like, outro it before.
We went over this. We went over this. Person who gets the first topic list does the intro. Person in the middle doesn't do anything. And the person who has the last topic list gets the outro. You get the outro.
Oh, I forgot.
Oh, like you forget everything. Like our recording times.
I didn't miss it. I'm still here.
We had to call you.
Yeah, but that's because I was asleep, not because I was like.
But you would have missed it.
Forget.
If we didn't call you.
No.
Yes.
Please stop. You're being mean. See, this is why everyone loves me more than they love you. Because you're unpersonable.
Diesel, I don't think that's very accurate.
Okay.
Shh. Who has more subs?
Shit. I gotta do the outro. You need to fucking
be quiet.
Oh,
now you want me to be quiet.
Yeah. All right. All right. So if you enjoyed this episode, please make sure to subscribe and or follow wherever you're listening, whether that be on SoundCloud, iTunes, or YouTube. Subscribe to the channel and follow us on Twitter at loudmouse_, where we will have updates and memes about things that you enjoy. You can find us all on our personal Twitters down in the links below. Or YouTube. I don't remember what's there.
It's
anyway,
YouTube.
What he said.
You also told them to subscribe twice.
You never want them to forget.
Also, last thing. Please don't scream in a library. Subscribe to Loudmouth.
No, do it.